Hi fellas, David here. Happy Homebrew Wednesday. It's been a while. Done a couple of beer reviews on the Lauren Hardy night, which went down pretty well. Tonight I'm drinking. This is the Wilco Real Ale. Wonderful clear, as you can see. This was on, I did the video on the kegs about pressure barrels, the voted keg and the king keg. And it's worked out really well, that one. It's very malty drink and it's sessionable, holding its head, lacing's there. Nice little session beer for myself, really. Nothing too extravagant, but it's pretty decent. Right, beer mail in first. Lovely box here from Mr. Christian Brewbeer. So we'll go through what Christian sent us. It's a BPA, 4.4%, very, very dark. I will find out exactly what these are from Christian. I'm not really had a chance to message him. I've also got another one, Experimental Bitter, 4.2%, lovely strength for a bitter, with Fuggles hops, you can see there. And that's looking quite clear already. That one has been shook up a bit. And the postman. What else do we have? Glass bottle this time. We have Brew in a Bag, 4.5% Twisted Stunt. Now, if you had a few many of those, it could also be a tongue twist, or it could work out something very rude. Twisted Stunts with a C here and a C there. So, go to that one. And a beer I've seen many of, never actually tried this. It's very popular on the continent. Veltins, Pilsner. You won't often see me drinking from cans for another reason, and I tend to buy bottles basically to use them again for my own brews. So that's that. Little swig of that. Do you guys want to do a two can kit? There was no additions in this, I don't think, off the top of my head. And it was pretty decent. Okay, a bit of shopping this week. Called in Wilco's, not seen these before. It's a stick-on digital thermometer. Obviously not as accurate as an STC 1000, but for your fermenters, so even your barrels, something like that. If you want to condition them. They are pretty accurate, and I think I've got 5 or 6 Demijohns now, so just handy to put them on there, put them in a cupboard, just make sure they're somewhat, you know, somewhat within temperature. Okay, that's that one. And last but not least, I've got a beer mail going out. It's going to be this weekend. This is to Aussie Brew, John Owens. Cheers, John, and fantastic beer the other night. That were reviewed down really well, and I wasn't pulling any punches. It really was a cracking beer, and it's one I would actually look to do myself, and that's a great beer. So what have we got first for John? We've got Laurel's Laughter. See there? The label, I can't read back to front. It's 5.6%, based on a Wilco Pilsner kit I actually used. Top of my head, I did use a dedicated lager yeast. It has been lagered. I think it's about 3 months in the bottle now. Very crisp tasting, and I did dry hop it as well. No, I didn't dry hop it. I put some extra hops in mini boil, if I remember rightly. I'll put the some instructions in when I send it to you, John. But there's some hops in there, and I can't think off the top of my own head what they are. Okay, and this is Hardy's Head Cracker. You see a bit of a theme coming on here, can't you? That's 8% ABV. This is to sent down to the club, and they did it down pretty well. That's based on a Wilco's, again, Wilco's kit. It was, can't think of something. Not the stout, the Nuki Brown Ale, I think it was. I did put some additions in there, and that, a bottle in. I added, I think it was 10 millilitres of bourbon, and they did bump the ABV up, and that was a cracking drink, that. I did a similar stout last year. Went down pretty well. Not something you would have too many of, but I'm sure you'll enjoy that one, John. Right. Also, one I did on my own account. It's a John Bull IPA kit. Wasn't really going to send you this one, John, because that pale ale you sent me was absolutely fantastic, and this doesn't match up. It's not a bad drink, but it's not anything like the Young's kit that I did try of yours. And last but not least, only three left in the country, actually in my garage. I never actually reviewed this. I brewed it last year. I don't know if you guys saw it. It was a Columbus Brown Ale, 7.6%. Came out a lot stronger, so I actually called it my Columbo's Revenge. And after a couple of those, I'm sure you would see why. So I'll wrap it up there, guys. I've got them four for you, John. I want to do a couple more labels. I'll get them done this week. I'll get them out to you, and hopefully you can do some reviews on your Tuesday Tipple program. So thanks for watching, guys. Enjoy the rest of the week. Oh, one last thing. I saw a good video. I've not been watching many videos. I've been away then catching up with work and that. But I did see Tube Dino's, cheers Dino, video, and he found Nat Rogerson in his brew pot. Now, I knew Nat Rogerson was going to return sooner or later, and I won't, not want to spread rumours, as you know, but he was last seen talking to Wayne Rooney, something to do with a clinic. Now, I don't know what, and I wouldn't like to say, but have you got any answers, just put in the comments below, and I'm sure they'll get around to reading them. So cheers, guys, thanks for watching. Happy homebrew, take care, and I'll catch you later.